Hi everyone, Johnny here from the State Library of Victoria. Welcome to the next in our creator series. In this one, we're going to have a look at how to create a photo collage from the copyright-free image pool that's recently gone up on our website. So to get to that, head to our website, slv.vic.gov.au. We're going to go search and discover and then click on browse this section. Next, we will find a little search bar for the digital image pool, and we can click into there and use keywords to search for all kinds of different images that we can use for our own creative project. So let's see, we're going to type drum and we get all these different kinds of images. When you find one that you want, you can click on it. Then once it comes up, right click and save image as. I've already found quite a few that I'm going to use. For example, this one in the next tab of this boy with the drum. And I've already saved those. And the tool that we're going to use for this collage is Adobe Photoshop, which is a very, very well-known program you've probably heard of. They do offer a free trial for 7 days. They also have a subscription service, and we provide it on some of our computers in the library. For those of you who aren't able to access it any of those ways, I will also mention this tool, Photo-P. This is one of a number of different Photoshop alternatives, a free online alternative. It has a lot of the same tools, pretty much identical tools. So the steps that you're going to see me do as I go through it in Photoshop will translate very well to using a tool like this if you don't want to or can't get your hands on Photoshop. So here we are inside Photoshop. To get started, we're going to go over here and hit open to open up one of the photos that we've downloaded from the image pool. These are the ones that I've already downloaded, and I'm going to select one. The first one we want to select here is the background. So I'm going to use this one as a background and press open. Once we're in the program, I'll just explain the layout a little bit, and even if you're not going to use Photoshop, chances are other photo editors that you use are going to be very similar in their layout, so this should translate across to them pretty well. We have a set of tools over on the left, and we're going to learn about a couple of those today. We have our photo layers down in the bottom right, and as we add in different images, we're going to see that we get a new layer for each image, and we can arrange them one on top of the other, just like you would with pieces of paper, cutting out and laying them on top of each other. We also have menus across the top, as you would be used to probably from all sorts of other programs, and they have different commands that we can do. Before we move on, the first thing I'm going to do is unlock this layer. Now, when you bring in an initial image or open an initial image, it often has this little lock sign on it, which means you can't change it drastically. To unlock it, I'm going to duplicate it by dragging it down to this little button, and it will then duplicate. We now have background copy, and the one underneath I'm going to select and press the little bin icon to delete that. Are you sure you want to? Yes, please. Next, we're going to change the shape of this photo. So I want to work with a square shape for my collage, partly because I think it might look quite good as an album cover, but also if it wants to go onto Instagram or something like that later, then we would use the square kind of format there. So to do that, I've got my selection tool over here. At the moment, it's set to elliptical, but I want a square, so I'm going to click and hold, and then if I move across to the menu that pops up, I can choose the rectangular marquee tool. Then if I click and drag whilst holding the shift key, it will make a perfect square for me, and I can move that around until I get the kind of crop that I want. Then we go up to the image menu in the top of the screen, and we're going to choose crop. Okay, so what we need to do next is start bringing in the other photos and images that we want to layer on top and combine for our collage. The way I'm going to do that is by flicking across to the folder that has all of my images, and I'm simply going to drag and drop into the first image. We then get these little white boxes on the corners and the sides of the image, and you can click and drag those to resize the new image how you'd like it. Once you've resized it, you can go up to the little tick at the top of the screen here and accept that change. If you ever want to get back to resizing it again, we would go to the edit menu from the top and transform, and we have a scale option in there. So now that we've got our image resized so that it fits somewhat into the scene, we still want to make a few more changes by cutting out the background and having it blend in better into the collage. If we look down in the layers area, which we mentioned before, we'll see we have a new layer, and that is the new image that we've just dragged in. Before we can make more changes to that, we need to do a process to that called rasterize. If we right click on the layer, we can go to the menu that pops up and choose rasterize layer. Essentially, another way of saying that for now is that it's going to make this fully editable by allowing you to edit the pixels in the image. We can provide a link to a more in-depth explanation of that. But for now, just make sure that you do that before these next steps. And then we're going to look at some of the tools up here in Photoshop. So the first tool we're going to talk about is the lasso tool. So as you can see, when you point at it, it shows you a little preview of what that's going to do, but I'll show you as well. If we click on that, what we can then do is make a freehand selection, sort of cutting out something in an image. Now, just doing it freehand with the lasso is very inaccurate, very difficult to get a good selection. So there is another way to do it, which is if we click and hold on the lasso tool, we'll get another option here called magnetic lasso. Now, the way that one works is it will sort of hug and cling to the edges of the image on its own. I've just clicked once there to begin the selection, and as I just slowly bring my mouse along the edges of the boy's head here, you can see it creating these little anchor points. You can drop your own anchor points by clicking. And if you make a mistake with one, you can press delete to go back. But it also can generate them itself fairly accurately. And it's also pretty accurate at finding the edges of the image for you. I will just close up this selection as an example. The way you close it up is you go to your first point that you clicked on and click on that, and it will make the selection. We will then want to delete what's around that. So we can right click on it and press select inverse. At the moment, we have selected the boy's head, but we want to select everything other than the boy's head. So we press select inverse and then press delete, and it will delete everything else around that. The next tool we're going to look at is the magic wand. So the magic wand lives up here, and it works very well at selecting blocks of color. It's a color-based tool, and so it'll work well with this flower picture, as that has a solid background of color. If we click on the color that we'd like to remove, it will detect it all, and we can simply press delete to remove it. We can then go in and delete all the other little blocks of color that we want to get rid of. To do that more accurately, we might also have to zoom in, and to do that we can go to the view menu and zoom in, or the keyboard command for that is command plus.